Welcome back if you've already subscribed. If you're new or visiting, welcome to the channel. I'm just gonna do a quick overview of a trade I took. This is Dow Jones, US 30. If you're not familiar with Dow Jones. Okay, so this is what I saw on the 4 hour. So we're gonna do 4 hour, 15 minute, and then 1 minute that I use for my entry. And this is how it went. I saw this area over here. That's an order block. Fair value gap. And it was on Friday, so I knew the high and low of the week is probably already made. And it's made by Wednesday's and Tuesday's trading. So that's what I saw. It went into the order block. Price went into the order block Friday morning. I usually don't trade Fridays, but if the opportunity presents itself, why not go for it? Bum bum bum. Then let's go into 15 minute. So I've already got my buys. I'm only selling. Only selling for this Friday because it went into the fair value gap and this order block. Let's go 15 minutes. I was waiting for a breaker structure, which I get. Let me just make sure where I saw that. This is the high low breaker structure. So this is my breaker structure. That was the breakout structure, and now I'm looking for entry patterns, and I did that on the 1 minute chart because we already broke structure to the downside, came into the, wait, let me just mark up, came into this fair value gap. Came into that fair value gap and this order block and broke structure. So now I'm expecting, let me just mark that as breaker structure, breaker structure, breaker structure. Just use this one and then nope. Do that. Then breaker structure 15 minute. That's the order block, came off of our order block, and we're still inside this fair value gap, massive fair value gap here. There's a fly. Now we're going to the 1 minute chart, and now I started by marking up my time. So 12 o'clock to 1:30. That's the first thing I marked up, and then 1:30 till 3. So what I'm doing here is I'm marking up. Man, I don't trade on this, so I don't even look at charts on this. I'm just using this for YouTube's sake. It's easier charting. Now on the 1 minute, what I'm looking for is, first and foremost, I saw inside here there was a run on these highs. So we've already had our breaker structure. Now, after the breaker structure, I'm seeing a run on these highs. So that I looked at as a liquidity raid. So it shouldn't go back up into that area. And then I waited to 2 o'clock. Right there. So it's 2 to 3 silver bullet time. This, I could have taken the trade earlier. Up here. Inside this. Let me just zoom in a bit more so you can see the full picture. So there's a breaker structure all the way back here. It went up, took these highs out up here, made lower lows, made a low, and inside here I could have been a sell already, but I just decided to wait in case it wants to go higher before 2 o'clock. Then when 2 o'clock came around, I actually took this trade at 2:01. I sold down here. There's a massive fly. I took the trade short here while the candle's still going up. My stop was above this highs, 28 points, and my target was below these lows. 190 point target. And I'm explaining to you why it was that. My initial target was down here. These lows, sorry. That was my initial target. 1 to 3. But after I've seen. I'm just going into the play. You find that point. So here, this is why I should screenshot my charts. Flip, I forgot where I anchored the fib from, because there's an exact point and a reason for it. High is high, swing low, and then make a. I think it's from here. To make sure. These lows, yeah. That was my initial target, sorry. The 1 to 1.3, and then I saw it go to like take this liquidity super quick, and I was like, no, I need to extend this target because the market is moving too fast. It's gonna give me more profit, so I extended it to these lows, 1 to 3, and then. After I saw this big red candle inside here, I realized I'm not targeting the right area and I should be targeting the lows made in London. So if you watch the video on One Trade Setup for Life by ICT, he speaks about which liquidity areas you should be aiming for during which time, things like that. And this is the actual liquidity I should have been aiming for. If greed didn't set in. Oh man, I want to use this. So it's the low between, let me just mark up this as a box, between 2 in the morning and 5 in the morning, US time. So if I was selling, I should have aimed for something inside this area or the actual low of this area, which is this candle. And you see, it just touches it and moves away. But no, I'm smarter. So I targeted these lows, which I shouldn't have. And my reason being, once I took these lows, I saw that ES and so US 500 and US 100, Nasdaq and ES, NQ and ES. Were taking the lows of 8:30, so I thought the Dow could just take the lows. I'll target that and then be on my day. Have a good weekend, or 1 to 6 hour trade. But no, it didn't touch my target. I took some risk of the trade after it hit, so it hit there, reversed. I saw fair value gap forming and I took some risk off the trade. I put it above this it down here. So let's just do this again. Short position. I move my stop just below this fair value gap, or above, sorry, this fair value gap. So let's look at that difference. So I locked in, how much is that? 60 points, it's like 1 to 3. And I didn't close out any other positions, even though I added a bit on top of here. Yeah. So I put those trades at break even and I moved my stop down to below here, got stopped out, and that was my Friday trade. So all in all, should have had a 1 to, what is that? If I was choosing my proper targets, 1 to 5. I think my stop was a bit wider. Yeah, it was covering those eyes. So it should have been a 1 to 5, but instead I got out at like a 1 to 2. Still not bad, not terrible. It's Friday, like ending a week. Made a few $100, but yeah, could have been better. Could have made $1,000 for Friday and had an amazing weekend. But you know, if you don't plan your trade and you don't trade your plan, you're not going to reap the rewards. That's Schema Scalper signing out. Have a safe festive season. Cheers, bye.